In this video, you'll learn how to mask glass and transparent objects using Photoshop. I'll start by explaining the concept, and with a free action, you will be able to do the whole process very easily in a few seconds. Let's jump into Photoshop and get started. First, let's open the background image that is provided in the description below. Then, I'm going to add this gradient to explain the difference between multiply and screen blending modes. This gradient starts with 100% black and then fades to 100% white. And as you may know, every image consists of three main tones: shadows, midtones, and highlights. Shadows are the darkest areas, highlights are the brightest areas, and midtones are the colors in between. If we change the blending mode to multiply, all bright pixels will go away and only dark pixels will stay. And on the other hand, screen is the opposite of multiply, and it keeps bright pixels and hides the dark ones. So let's say multiply keeps dark areas, which are shadows, and screen keeps bright areas, which are highlights. And we can control the intensity of the visible pixels by clipping a levels layer like that. And by moving the midtone slider, we can increase or decrease the shadows like that. And this is the main idea of our today's tutorial. Now let's have a real-life example to see what's going on. Let's import our image from File, Place Embedded. Increase its size and position first. And since the surrounding area is completely white, I can use the Magic Wand tool to do the selection. After making a selection around the background, I'm going to create a mask from this selection. Then select the mask itself and press Ctrl and I to invert the selection. Now the bottle is isolated. Let's duplicate its layer with Ctrl and J. Right-click the duplicated layer and convert it to a smart object. Hide the bottom layer and rename the top one Shadow. Change its blending mode to Multiply. As you can clearly see, Multiply keeps the shadows and hide the highlights. Now let's create a levels layer and clip mask it to the shadow layer. Move the middle slider to control the intensity of the output shadows as mentioned before. Now select both layers while holding the Ctrl key, then press Ctrl and J to duplicate them. Rename the duplicated layer Highlights and rechange its blending mode to Screen. Drag the middle slider to see how it affects the highlights. In my case, I will keep it very low like that. And here is the final transparent glass. So we have here the highlights separated in one layer, and the shadows in another layer. And all midtones are now hidden to give us this transparent look to our final result. Now let's group all layers to see the before and after. And this is the main idea of our today's tutorial. Let's first import the action that we're going to use today. I made this action for free thanks to our Patreon community. You can join us there and get unlimited access to our all projects. Now let's open one of the images we have. You can download these images from the description below. First, make a selection around your object. I will use this Select Subject button to let Photoshop do the selection for me. Once the selection is ready, open the action and select Run. And with your layer selected, click on this little run icon to run the action. Drag that result group and drop it inside the main document. Change its position and size using Ctrl and T like that. Let's open the group and see what's there. As you can see, there are shadows, highlights, and other two layers, fill and color. Both layers are inactive as I applied a black mask to them. And you'll soon find out why I made them and how they'll be used. Let's first adjust the highlight slider as mentioned before, and also the shadow slider. No magic values right here. Just move the slider in both directions to find your optimum value. And let's grab a white brush with 100% opacity and flow. And after selecting the fill layers mask, start painting over that cork. This will bring back its original color. So fill will be used to bring back the original state of any solid part of the transparent object. Now let's move on to the next example. Since there is more than one object right here, I'm going to use the Object Selection tool. And by making a rectangular selection around the object, Photoshop will automatically select it like that. Now select the action from the Actions panel, and with your layer selected, click on the Run icon. Drag the result group to the main document. Set its position and size using Ctrl and T. Then start by adjusting the highlights levels as before, and also the shadows. If I move my object to darker or brighter region, the color of the oil will change as it interacts with the background below. And that's why I made this color layer. Just select its black mask. And with a white brush, start painting over the oil like that. This will fix that problem, and the color will be stable despite how dark or bright the background is. Finally, let's have another more complicated example. As you can see, this bottle of water has these reflections over it from the surrounding environment, and it seems impossible to mask out the glass right here. But since the highlights and shadows are not destroyed by these reflections, we can do it very easily. But please consider that if your object is over a busy background like that, the glass will be impossible to be isolated. Now let's select the bottle first with any selection tool. And with your layer selected, go and run the action. Drag the result group and drop it inside the main document. Adjust the highlights levels. Move the mid-tone sliders in both directions to see how it affects the overall result. And also the shadows levels. The bottle is now transparent, but I'm still having those reflections all over it. To hide them, let's add a black and white layer to both shadows and highlights layers to desaturate them like that. Finally, let's select the mask of the fill layer and with a white brush, set its flow to 1000 and start painting over the areas you want to show. Make sure that your brush hardness is 100%. To paint precisely, you can make a selection around the part you want to reveal and with your white brush tool, paint inside the selection like that. Don't forget also to paint over that cap. Let's select the black mask of the color layer and paint over it with a 5% flow white brush. Paint over the bottom of the bottle like that. Also, paint over the edges and inside the bottle to bring back some color tint like that. And here is the effect of both color and fill layers. That's it for today. Don't forget to check out this next tutorial to learn how to make your own digital paintings without any drawing skills in Photoshop. Thanks for watching and see you next time.